Oh, okay.
Okay, see. In the area. And we also have the slaughterhouse south of, on 113, and at Superior Farms.
Mm.
Okay, it used to be Stoven Brothers, and they sold it, and Superior Farms bought it. But in that, and there used to be one up by CVS Pharmacy across the street.
Up on North First Street?
Yeah.
Okay.
That big empty area.
Mm-hmm.
There was, Armor was there, and it was a slaughterhouse.
Oh.
Okay. And it was the only two lamb slaughterhouses west of the Mississippi at that
really?
Time. And now that's, I'm not sure that if, you know, this may only be, I don't know if there's another one or not,
mm-hmm.
Lamb, because this is what Superior Farms does.
Oh.
They just do lamb.
Okay.
So, and so it could be just the only one.
I guess Dixon's a big lamb town then, huh?
Yes. Well, one time they used to call it lamb town.
Oh, okay. Great.
It's been called very many different names.
So,
yeah. So anyway, they had a dog.
Mm-hmm.
And a local dog.
I see Alan Ladd's up here in this one.
One.
So is this the local dog from Dixon right there?
Yeah.
Wow. And what was that dog's name?
Charles?
No, that's Charles? Oh.
No. Let me see. That could have been the dog owner.
Oh.
Oh, excuse me. Oh, okay. His dog is called Sam. Of course. Sam. Oh, pretty interesting. Okay.
But you can see, basically, yeah, the dog was trained with lambs
okay.
to be able to
great.
Do that.
Now, what do we have on this? Oh, a little gift shop right here, Carolyn.
Yes.
Huh? What are your t-shirts going for?
Well, the t-shirts go for $20,
mm-hmm.
and the sweatshirts go for, depending on the size, $40, and different things, you know. And this
okay.
is because it says milk farm, because we had that restaurant out there.
Okay.
Okay. You still have the big, tall sign. It's still there, but it has
now
changed.
This is a must-have. I want to buy one of these.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah.
Oops. Okay. We'll hold on to that as you give us a run the little tour here. So a lot of these
there,
are
you probably I don't know. You come over the railroad tracks this way, I'm sure, on
right.
A Street.
Okay.
I don't know if you go up and down on First Street, 113 very much.
Yes, we do. We go to Walmart.
Oh. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, like that place up there.
So this house that's in there is the house by the railroad tracks.
Okay.
Oh.
The one that they have fixed up.
Yeah.
And it says it's the Kilkenny home. Well, Kilkenny moved into it in 1913.
Oh, so okay. The house was there already.
The house was already there.
Mm.
And before Kilkenny's moved in, it was the McCune family that lived there. And then before that, it was, and I can't remember the name of the family, but it was another family that actually built the house.
I see.
And they built it in 1877, I think it was.
Oh.
So it's been there for a while, obviously.
Okay.
But the guy that worked on it, and he's fixed it up and everything, they had a fire in there.
Oh, that's the Kilkenny house right here.
Years ago.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So he had to go in and redo and fix up and everything. But I think, you know, when you have an older home, you have to do that.
Mm-hmm.
Keep it up. Electrical, plumbing, all that needs to be kept up. So.
Amazing.
Now, are all these pictures of homes that are still here?
Okay. They're not. Some are.
Mm-hmm.
Some aren't. Farmers Exchange. That's over on B Street. Well, if you looked in between down the alley there, it's now the Moose Lodge.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Okay. That's the Moose Lodge.
Some of these... That doesn't exist anymore. It burned in 1920. This is gone. This was on B Street also, facing Farmers Exchange, but it got torn down and that's become the parking lot for First Northern Bank.
Oh, okay.
Okay, which is right there. And this is the same building, just can't. Different view.
Right.
And of course, the Mayfair is a big thing, and it's the longest continuing fair in the state.
Really?
Mm.
It used to be the longest continuously running fair, but we had to take the time off because of the pandemic.
Oh, yeah.
But anyway.
Okay.
And then this is the family that donated 10 acres.
Oh, the Dixon family.
To start the town. Because they knew the railroad tracks were coming through here. And the thing was, is Sillyville and Main Prairie and Tremont all moved kind of this way, all together to be by the railroad tracks. And they had donated all that money, so they're going to name the town Dixon. Well, it was supposed to be spelled like that, but it wound up being spelled
D-I-N.
Okay.
But anyway. Yeah, we just had a cemetery tour on Wednesday.
Oh, we missed that.
Yeah. Hmm. That was really good.
Okay.
I'm sure they'll have more of that again. Too.
Great. What do we have here? Do you have a jazz band here at Dixon?
They had a jazz band here.
Hmm.
It was a lot of them have passed.
Mm-hmm.
They have gone on now. But they were very active in the 70s and 80s and everything. And they even... Where a group went to Hawaii and everything to entertain. They really had a good time. They really enjoyed it.
Mm. It's nice.
And all good friends.
Sacramento Bee in 1966. That's great. King.
I know, jazz bands seem to go up and down.
Now we passed by the Dixon High School. That's still around, but it doesn't look like that.
And no, they had to tear it down and they started again.
Oh.
And now this is where the John Knight Middle School is.
Okay.
Okay. The high school is down 113 further.
Mm-hmm.
And then it comes around, and it's really a nice building.
Right.
This building, you would think,
wow, that's nice. It's not there anymore, is it?
No, it started falling apart.
What? Oh.
Wow.
Yeah, it started falling apart. And so they tore it down.
That's too bad.
It is too bad.
Yeah.
And then, of course, in the knee, this one, this is where the Anderson is. It's on C Street. And they had to tear it down because of earthquake, okay, to make sure. But they said, what a heck of a time they had tearing it down. They had to take a wrecking ball to it. It was so hard to get torn down. And then some of these, 1902, one of our docents, he always points out is his grandfather, who is, he's kind of blurry on the end over here, but his grandfather was in a school in these camps that we had, and they liked it here. A lot of them liked it here so much that they were sponsored by the camp owners, and they stayed on after that.
Look at this sign.
Oh, yeah. Batavia Road. This is where they're at here. They used to use these old Quonset huts back in Vietnam and World War II.
From Travis.
That's what they were made out of. Corrugated metal right here.
Was torn down in the early 50s.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
And Sillaville, that town got moved over, okay? It was developed a lot more than Main Prairie was or Tremont.
Mm-hmm.
And they rolled their buildings over.
Wow.
You know, with the logs and stuff and pulled them over.
That's how they, wow.
And the Methodist Church is how that church got over here. It's over on the other side of the railroad tracks. They said that they couldn't get it over the railroad tracks, so they just left it on that side.
Okay.
But there was quite a few other homes that they did the same thing. They moved them over, and some of the original buildings that don't exist now, but they did roll them over.
And these are all handmade, right, Carolyn?
Are these all authentic?
Authentic.
Oh,
turn
yeah.
of the century dresses.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. This one has got a picture of one of the ladies in it, an actual dress. And I'm telling you, that is a super skinny person.
Yeah.
Because that.
Wow.
No way. But this was his second wife. He had been married, had 7 or 8 kids, and then remarried. He was a widower, and then married her, and had another 7, 8 kids.
Wow.
Very interesting. Look at those shoes. Can you imagine wearing something like this?
Oh, look how skinny.
Wow.
He had the small feet. Very small feet.
Well, then you wondered, did your toes even go up there, or they just went so far, or what, you know? And this is what I always like, is the dance card.
Oh,
okay. You have, I didn't even know, you got order of dances, okay? And you have the polka, the shottish, the two-step, the waltz, and you know who you were gonna dance with and everything. It's amazing. It's cute. And this was, what is, there is a year on here.
1898. Dixon Library on B Street, 1919.
Yeah, we have the Carnegie Library, which is really nice. When we moved here, they hadn't added an extension yet. It was just, that was the library at that time. So now that they have, it's nice that they have the extension, but it is attached to the original library though, too.
Should we keep this going or the original back and forth? And thank you, Carolyn.
Your mom.
And then what happened was everyone voted to keep DIX on it.
So what do we have out here?
So there was the milk farm.
And it's still there along with...
Well, the sign is, not this one. This was an artist rendering thing. It's more, it looks more like that. But, you know, he started this, and it lasted until 1986.
Wow.
A long time. And a lot of people, the reason they even get this, they remember going back and forth on the freeway.
Because of that.
Yes, in the restaurant, or they would stop because it used to be like, you know, going up to the mountains for snow or whatever, and then down to the Bay Area, it was like a halfway mark, and so they would stop and eat. And kind of like the first nut tree.
Right.
You remember the nut tree?
Yeah.
So, Diane, what do you have here that... It's pretty interesting up here, you want to say. Oh, well, great. This is going to be out there eventually. You know, I'll have to go home and work on it, but I wanted to come and check this place out for myself and see what you had out here.
You love the history and...
I love the history of Dixon. It's great. It's a nice small town.
Wait, now, where did you guys come from?
Sassoon.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we're not too far. Right, right.
That's a nice little town. We grew up in San Francisco,
right.
So we're born and raised in San Francisco.
Mm-hmm.
And
right.
We moved out to Sassoon. We lived there 30 years.
30 years?
Yes.
And then you're wanting to just be in a smaller place, right?
Right, absolutely.
Well, your retirement.
Right. We were in a two-story home and we thought, oh, we're going to get older. We don't want to deal with the stairs.
Right,
oh, thank
right.
You.
And then we found out they were building a 55 and over community in Dixon. Perfect.
Right. Right. Now, can we have one of your books here? We'd like to pay for that.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Certainly.
Yeah.
Yes. And we can help you with that. And
okay.
Then I'll be sure and get you our little brochure, which talks more about who
there
we
you go.
Are.
Great.
We'd love to have you join us tomorrow if you're presentation and have you get more involved. If
great.
You love history, you'd love to.
And that'll be at the community church only. I mean, this won't be open, right?
That's right. Right. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, during the fair?
Do you are not community the Methodist church?
The Methodist church.
Yeah.
Right up the street up there, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. Yes. Probably one of the most interesting historical things for me are the schools. I don't know if you looked at the pictures
yes,
around
yes,
the corner.
Right. Mm-hmm. Interesting. Great.
See, she could tell you more.
Yes. I'm sure.
Yes. Okay.